Hey.
Hi.
We're back with another Saddle Club. After recording for 7 minutes without pressing record, this is episode, what did we say it was? Episode 12, season one, jumping to conclusions. Like when you start riffing on a show without actually recording anything. Let's go.
You shouldn't have said anything. They won't say all these polished lines. What's the carriage doing there?
Actually, I didn't even see that.
Right, just see in the corner there. I didn't pick up
Red,
that.
Red is in the background polishing leather as he always does.
He's just chomping the...
Veronica is horseless.
If she sticks her nose up any higher, she won't be able to see where she's going.
They've got Veronica on a massive horse.
It's on Patch.
Doesn't matter. Hatch doesn't look like he wants to Hatch go anywhere Hatch. Anyway. I'm not going to waste
Hatchet.
My time on
Hatchet.
The
That's what he's going to get face, in the trips.
Yeah. Yeah. I killed one fucking Stop horse, I'll kill another, she says. And it's here. Everyone's happy. They're happy to tease Veronica, she just fell off a horse. Meanwhile, only 2 weeks ago, she fell off one, broke her arm, and resulted in the death of a horse. Now it's just laughing fodder.
Oh, no, the thing that she's worried about and that everyone jokes about is that, oh, look at her on some lowly horse that's not a thoroughbred.
Mm. Stevie. I got... Oh, Veronica.
Falling, jumping, kissing. Yeah. Falling shit.
Yeah, Veronica constantly falls. Yeah.
Picking. Those sandbags.
Hands up in the air.
Woo! We won Saddle Club.
Here we go.
And that's got to be the worst attempt at tying a horse.
What did she tie? A horse string, I think you believe.
Yeah, she just chucks it on a bush.
Yeah.
It doesn't even get tangled up on
She's
anything.
Got all these trees to choose from, but she hangs it over an oleander bush. Come on, the poisonous one. She's fucking idiot. Whose side are you on? I didn't know that Boy Heartthrob was still, like, in the show. You haven't seen him for a little while. That's
Veronica. I'm not actually convinced he's a boy.
Ooh, the glare. It's the famous Stevie glare. Has the glare finished? No. Still going.
But it ends in disappointment.
Here's Veronica trying to shave her eyelashes off with a Gillette razor. I've been riding for longer. I've got a bookshelf full of trophies. Christy's just spotted a boy, new boy walk in.
He doesn't like horses because he flinches stepping in shit.
Actually, I think I saw him in the tack room. The what? Where are the right yeah, and he was the Irish guy that was on Neighbours. Hey, Jake, I thought I heard your voice. Immediately chokes him out for doing a racist Irish accent.
Yeah. To be sure. He's just got to stand there and take it.
There's going to be Christy and Veronica tension over the new heartthrob in town.
Meanwhile, you've already got tension between Stevie and
look, I mean, when you and Boy Heartthrob.
Boy Heartthrob. No way, he's a Boy Heartthrob. He's just so... Does he become a heartthrob?
He reminds... No, I doubt it. He reminds me of the sort of the chunky kid from Small Wonder. They put him in the show like to be the heartthrob, but he just hasn't panned out.
Oh, he's non-threatening male role model.
Yeah, and that didn't work out because like studly guys are what's required in the show. Like
take
Max,
a look.
Yeah,
Maximilian is his real name.
No, I'll never finish this. Paperwork for my application to acting school. Experience? None. Well, I appreciate the concern, Red,
but are we talking about me? He's competing with this young stud who's got experience in eating hay. Polishing bridles. Well, yeah.
How much time do you want off?
Just one day.
Which one?
Saturday.
Not Saturday, Red.
He wants he wants to have a Saturday off. Does he get any leave?
No, he's there constantly, 7 days a week.
He works as a casual. He's paying him like junior rates.
Max is talking
to him. He's told him it's a condition of the contract that you don't have any days off.
And here we see the return of the journalist. who Max fell in love with.
Great to see you.
And you know that there's going to be tension there because she's the...
She'll put in a foot in it because she doesn't like horses. And Max will get all fucking shut up.
Well, he already knows that she doesn't like horses, but she's allowed back in. Whereas you've had Guitar Boy, you know, almost step in shit and goes, ugh, you know. So you've got two love interests from the outside. Symbolise that don't like.
Yeah, it's like the fucking Waco compound, you know, this place.
Yeah, you know it's never going to work out.
Sure. I'm working on something new right now.
Christy sort of like grabs the neck of the guitar and starts running her fingers up and down the fretboard. Oh no, here comes Veronica.
I'm Veronica. He's Jake.
How you doing, Veronica?
Coping.
She sort of like wipes her head with a $100 bill.
I
don't know where this came from.
She rolls it up in a well-practiced straw.
Come on, Christy, let's go.
And we see Boy Heartthrob in the background looking off, on with his mouth open. Doesn't know how the Irish Lothario does it.
Thanks for the lesson, Jake. Impart your magic on me.
Yeah. Is it leprechauns or something?
I'm Phil. You right here?
No, I'm waiting for Red.
Just making sure.
What are they doing in the background? They may... There's two girls that's standing there in the kitchen. Looks like they're looking at some...
They're cooking a horse.
Yeah.
What?
1,001 recipes for ways to cook
making, horse. Yeah, straw soup.
So how do you do it?
I don't know.
I'm trying to ask this girl out, but it's not happening. I know I'm doing something wrong, but I don't know what.
Have you tried heterosexuality?
What? Well, you're the only boy at Pine Hollow.
You mean like compliments?
Sure. Look, girls love it whenever you tell them that their hair looks good.
They've got nice potatoes or...
Oh, I've got to tell them their hair looks good. Cool.
You've got nice hair.
Your eyes are like pimming swools.
You're my horse density. Uh-oh.
Ransel, what's wrong?
Is all the oleander is eaten?
Yeah, the oleander she rubbed in its face.
Max!
Yeah?
Yeah?
It's the special horse grass that she likes to eat.
That's a horse. Let's see.
Is it going to have a baby? Sure. Get my medical curtain. I'm just going to... The tent.
Yeah, I think so. She'll probably pick up during the morning.
These horses are always having fevers. I didn't realise fever was such a... You know, a prevalent thing.
It's because they flog these horses like around the clock.
What's wrong, Prancer?
Like their junior staff.
If you can't do it, get out of the way.
Says Veronica as she rides another horse straight into a tree.
Explodes.
Yeah.
You better call it a day, Lisa.
Why would you take... The horse was sick at the beginning of the day. Why would you take it out? Fucking good call, dickhead.
It had a horse medical certificate.
Yeah. Oh, run it out. Yeah.
Hey.
He's on horse.
Fuck your That's shit.
It's Chad. I wish I had a brother who could share his clothes. So do I. You didn't ask? He'll never know I was.
Oh, no. Just tips a glass of red cordial down the front of his shirt.
What do you do with soda? Most people drink it.
She could take it off.
Okay, I'll go get Mr.
That's right.
She will take it off and yeah, Studley's, Studley's just coming to the room. He's going to see a wet t-shirt. Get him.
Oh, that's an eyeful. They can't even use that shot.
Immediate stiffy.
She turns around, suddenly goes in slow motion. Her hair starts.
Like your shirt.
She what? Shakes her head back.
Your shirt.
Turns around with his prepubescent.
What's good about
me? Chests.
For one thing, the color. So I spilt a little soda on it. Glad you
missed it. Oh, you fucked up.
You got the glare.
I mean, you're dealing with a Canadian girl here. You've got to up the ante.
Here.
Yeah, let the 10-year-old girl look after the health of the horse. Max doesn't get medical attention for it.
Yeah, because the vet's busy down at mechanics.
You know, he's too busy banging a journalist in his office.
Yeah.
I don't consider Lisa a novice anymore.
Poor horse is all hot and sweaty and hard. And
you are definitely more.
But you killed a fucking horse last week, Veronica. So just check yourself.
I had to subtract many points from horse slithering.
It's all right, Max. I'm missing Patch anyway.
Just tomorrow.
Of course. Unless Prancer improves dramatically with me riding her. And believe me.
Oh.
Yeah, that's it. The horse has probably got a rash on its back from some cheap jobbers rubbing on it. Poor girl jobbers and boots. The foul taste of a poor girl's bit in its mouth.
Look, it's just for one day. You'll be back on Prancer in a flash. Not when Max sees how different she is with an experienced rider.
How is she boasting? She just killed a horse.
Maybe that's the thing, a horse was an accident. I'm starting to think, is she a horse killer? She's like a serial killer from the rich family.
Tell that to someone who cares, Phil.
Somehow always knows the senator. She can get away with it.
Red, did you check Prince's feed?
I double checked it.
I even tasted some of it.
I wonder what it can be then.
AIDS.
Is she wanting to be caught?
I don't know what's up with Prancer right now.
It's so melodramatic. It's like
caught doing what?
Oh, this is. I'm starting to. Veronica's behavior is all a cry for help.
Not even.
Because this is like she's.
No.
Murdering no jelly on jumps and then she's poisoning them and then she's not basically.
She hasn't done anything.
We had a girl.
But that's the inference. She's just going, I wonder.
No. She wants the horse for herself. That's what she wants.
Hey, Red.
Oh, I was starting to think it was more seedy and interesting than it was.
No, she just wants. She gets to ride the horse today.
Okay. So, you help out work here.
I just invented a whole subplot going, surely this JS
I'm not interested in horses.
So, what are you doing here, Jake?
Well, you see one girl spill a like, glass of cordial down her shirt, right. And you think it's Hamlet. It's there's like horse poisonings
aren't they
and.
A little young for you?
What can I say? Can't help it if they dig me.
Tipping poison on a horse's ear.
It was all those jokes we were making about having Cobalt's head in.
Take the job and hang around in, here. Get paid girl's for bed. It. You might get some rehearsals.
You stepped in shit, mate.
Oh, I thought that was deliberate.
I don't do horse manure.
Like, he's now trying to get. His attention. That's why he joined the band. He goes, yeah, I'll join the band. He can't actually play guitar himself. He just wants to get close.
Hey, Jake.
Oh, you're right. There is a poisoning.
The compliment thing.
Really? Well,
what is she doing? Is she giving a brand or some shit?
Are you sure?
What the fuck?
But she's already ignoring me. If I ignore her too, then we might as well
be on
different
planets. She's gonna give
you asked for my advice.
She's feeding the horse black jelly beans.
Right.
Yeah, they're the devil's jelly beans.
Hello, girl.
No self.
Oats. Some oats for you. Come on, Prancer. Eat up. We'll be flying over those jumps tomorrow.
Oh, she crushed up her mum's pills or something. Where is she getting this? This performance-enhancing...
Yeah, oats. Max has never seen anything like it. And he rubs oats into his hair and face every morning.
Excellent, Veronica.
He once ate Uncle Toby's ass. He loves oats that much.
Right, Lisa?
No, you're fucking useless on a horse, girl.
Stevie, you're up.
It's no wonder that she doesn't improve. No one gives her a chance at anything.
Hey, Lisa. I know how much Prancer means to you, so I'll let you call her out. It's the only way you'll get to ride her.
Lisa doesn't have to do your chores.
It's okay. I want to. I'll put Patch away, and then we'll take Prancer up to the quarry with us.
Why don't you ask Phil to come? No way, he totally insulted me yesterday.
So now that's got away from that poisoning thing and the whole drama about the horse, this is actually far more interesting. Mm. I have no idea what the... Oh, that's right. Stevie's got to go ask him out.
We're going out to the quarry trail. Do you want to come? Maybe. Maybe. Maybe I'm busy.
Playing hard to get. I mean, taking off. I mean...
Yeah.
Is there something in that fireplace?
Yeah.
Could be. Something not visible to the human eye?
He's got him to the specialized. Yeah. Just a little now. He has no idea where he is.
He just did the big fucking rile of oats.
Yeah, this show is actually all about soccer. He's at soccer practice. He's just imagined this whole horse riding scenario.
Like what? Something to make her look good and you look bad.
What do these girls want to hang out by? Like a little dangerous looking cliff edge there.
Why? Oh, come on. That's clearly a tree line there. Don't go beyond the danger zone.
Mm.
Or she gets the best out of the horse, and I don't.
That's what she wants you to believe.
We need to go talk to Veronica. You don't have any proof, so we'll find
some. They're on the case.
You coming? I'll catch you.
Solving horse
later.
Mysteries. One day at a time. We haven't seen this journalist again since she rocked up
yes,
with Max's
what
office.
Are they doing?
Max strangled her and he doesn't know what to do. In a fucking panic. He's been feeding her bit by bit to the horse. So the horse is sick.
I was just assuming they were having sex constantly in the office. I'm getting so confused about what the show is actually about. You're right.
Snoop through Veronica's bag. Steals a hair clip.
Aha. This proves she's been torturing Prancer.
With an eyelash. What are you girls doing?
She could be. All it proves is that Veronica is vain.
What are you girls doing going through?
Oh, why wouldn't you just stand there for a bit longer and hear them?
Mm.
You're going to hear girl gossip or you're going to actually hear what they're
where's
talking
everyone
about.
Else?
It's worth
Don't
taking
you mean,
a few
where's
moments.
Stevie?
Why would I want to talk to Stevie?
Because you like her.
Who says?
And she likes you.
Really?
Looks like it to me.
But every time I try to talk to her, she gets angry at me. And when I ignore her, she walks off.
Don't ignore her.
Do you reckon Saddle Club is meant to be from the perspective of, like...
I see the horse is Oleander.
That's Oleander.
You fucking idiot.
Poisonous?
I thought it was just bad filmmaking. I thought it was just bad filmmaking when you did see her, like, tie the horse up to an Oleander.
She didn't tie it. She just threw the horse strings at the bush. And then walked away from it.
You definitely owe her an apology.
Oh, no.
Stevie and Carol have something they want to say.
You're going to get busted for the wrong crime.
Oats. From my private.
Did you give her oats?
Just as a treat.
You know, you're not supposed to give her anything.
But she was hungry.
You gave her oats to boost her energy.
You've got to go before the anti-doping horse board now.
Explain the feed schedule very carefully.
Performance-enhancing oats.
What? You can't do that.
Just watch me.
And if you're lucky, I might.
Just watch me. I'm telling you, watch me. I want everyone to watch my acting.
It's Prancer. She's been poisoned.
You could have just said it was Oleander. You don't need to bring a... carry a poisonous piece of Oleander.
This is Wattle, the emblem of our land.
But it's poisonous to touch, and Dickhead is just sitting there holding a piece of Oleander. He'll fall over sick in a minute.
Temperature's pretty normal. Well, Prancer didn't eat very
he's
much.
He's been eating it for days.
Yeah. Be all right in about 24 hours. Now have a look at the boy who's clutching the poisonous plant.
Thanks.
She ate the Oleander and was sick the next
slumped
day.
Down like he's out in the concrete.
Didn't take her up that day. So, by the time Veronica wrote her, she was fine.
Well, congratulations to whoever knew that Oleander was poisonous.
Let's make out.
Thanks, Phil.
Oh, the kisses, the cuddling. Oh.
He's dry humping her.
Yeah.
He walks out with Oleander held in front of him.
Yeah. He's gonna eat some. Fall over dead down a well. Irish is gonna play a love song.
Why is this stranger just hanging around the stables? That's a workplace and there are miners there.
Oh, yeah. How does that work?
Don't worry. You had to be there.
There's no way.
Oh, hey, Ray. Are we still on for Saturday? Or are you, you know, going to stay here and clean up after horses?
I told you I have to work. Why don't you come help me out?
And let the guys down. No way. Oh, hey, hey.
There we go.
Thanks.
They're the outside the horse community strangers they're meant to be.
Yeah. Hey.
Because they're both afraid of shit.
At least one of the Germans is still alive.
Doesn't matter. You must be Red's friend.
Aye. So that means I'm having sex.
Jake's going to work for us.
This is my pasture, pal.
What?
Yes. Sharon.
Of course I am.
Good. Red will tell you what to do.
So he gives a big smack on the arse and chews his teeth.
It's going to cut to the inside of Max's office and it's going to be like a scene out of The Secretary. She's on the desk with a saddle on her back.
Jake and music. And what about Red?
It was a crush. But with Jake and me, it's a relationship. It's way more mature.
Oh, God, that is a pretty good...
Jake today. Who's it going to be tomorrow?
Impression of what Jake girls are like. We're so mature. And the day after that.
And the day after that. And the day after
that. Yeah, yeah.
Is it on my eyes or does she have a soft focus shot there?
It's her hair.
She's doing the rooter dance.
She's doing the rooter. She's spying through a crack in the wall of the Irish guy who's doing the rooter dance outside. Poetry, you know what he said. Now, she hasn't got soft focus. It's just that she never uses conditioner. Her hair is wispy.
He said, she needs a good trim.
Music will always keep us together. Okay, okay. This is what we're going to do. Let him decide.
Right, let's do it.
I love Christy. She's the greatest.
She's...
Nice shirt, Jake.
Yeah.
They're going to find her dead.
Yeah, very much. With
these two white witches get to her. Play?
I play the guitar.
I've always wanted to learn to play guitar.
Well, I can teach you.
Fuck off, she says. Really back off, come on.
That's really nice of you, Jake.
Oh, there you are. You said?
Oh, thank you, lucky stars.
Well, I'll be here if you need me for now.
She's way too old for him.
He must be so desperate.
Look, I got to go.
Hey, Red, wait up.
She's straight back onto Red. She hasn't wasted any time.
Okay. You know she's going to be the real deal.
Because
That's the only thing she's in. You never see her interact with any horse at any time.
No, no.
I don't think she's in wrong there.
Probably not. She's just Veronica's friend who hangs out there.
Yeah.
Great round, Lisa. Way to go.
But with that said, you never see Stevie actually ride much.
A horse is only as good as its rider, right, Veronica?
She doesn't have to. She can just stand there looking cool in a denim jacket. Max's horse has run off and fallen down a cliff.
He actually rode the journalist all the way out there. She's just having some water in a nearby creek now. He was. All the horses jumped over a log, and then he had to jump it too, like he's a fucking horse. Dead set, dick brain. You think they would have like redone the video clip at the end? Like, fair enough, they filmed this like right at the get go. The three main girls. And Veronica, but there's no Christy. Like, Christy should be, like, pissed off that she doesn't get to be included.
I think Christy's the imaginary friend.
Or at least alternate.
Maybe that's why you don't see her.
Yeah, or at least alternate and let her, like, have a song. Have the bad girls, like, you know, do every second week. They can do, like, fucking Runaways or Joan Jett songs and shit.
You could have each character having their own song. Then girls would say, which song do you like best?
Denim Jacket. Denim Jacket Dazzler. That's my favourite song.
I like when Christy sings Boys, Boys, Boys.
Yeah, I love Max, Max, Max. Can't act, act, act. That's my favourite song.
Oh,
I love boy heartthrobs. Boys, boys, boys. Just looking for a good time. So many confusing feelings. Trilogy.
That's what the show is.
Yeah. I'm going to step out for a second. All right, it's episode 13. Set up. You know someone's going to get tricked. Let's go. Oh, yeah. Hit new song they're promoting. Montage of horses eating grass, oats, and oleander trees.
Ooh. Pasture cows.
Pasture cows. Man, Stevie pony. Jumping, yeah. Some other girl we've never seen before.
Having a picnic. So many horses.
Raggedy horses, yeah.
Are they just doing really well? They've got. Are they meant to be Brumbies or something?
Yeah, I thought there was a shortage of horses at Saddle Club.
They only ride the same four horses all the time.
Yeah, all girls have to ride the same four horses.
He's crazy about her.
Oh, Max is still being romantic with a journalist.
Whoa, steady, girl.
She okay?
I think she hurt her leg.
Oh, another one.
Looks like her fetlock.
I better take a look.
I'm going to take a look at the 303.
I'll stay in the car. I hate horses.
Yeah, she's probably got work to do. She's probably pulling out her her notebook and she's writing...
What's wrong? Don't you like horses?
Some exposure piece.
They just don't like me.
You just have to get to know them. Go on, pat him.
Do it. Horse quickly bites her on the hand.
See?
Yeah, just stroke it a little.
Just grabs her hand, yeah, just... Oh, just sneezes, smothered over a shit.
You know horses?
More than I ever thought I would.
Francis, fine. Ready to
this
go?
This is just like that movie, Horse Gag, you made me watch, Max.
Ah, oh, it's not so bad. You can cover the stain with your purse.
Classy, Max. Go upstairs and grab one of your mum's fucking Fu Manchu outfits. Yeah. Put that on.
Do a whole wardrobe.
Yeah. She's passed out in her upstairs loft opium den.
Did he just say, oh yeah.
Yeah, it's the mum that goes around poisoning the horses.
Yeah.
Goes down a little for you, a little for me.
Well, the opium just like falls through the floorboards and like falls down into their chaff bags.
I'll call you.
What are they worried about that Max has got a girlfriend?
No, kiss of death. They know that.
Max needs major help.
Oh, what? So they're going to ruin Max's relationship?
No, I think they're trying to help. They're going, oh, no, they want it to work.
Oh, they want it to work.
They want it to work and they're going, oh, no, that's the kiss of death. You know, he needs help.
Mm.
Unless they're just talking about their love life, his love life in general.
See, I'm so used to the black jelly bean eaters that all they want to do is like poison romances. So they can get their hooks into whatever heart.
Yeah, this is the first time you've seen the girls getting interested in setting up other past pals.
Mm. Reading advice magazines, Dolly.
Lisa's very girly bedroom.
If we're going to help Max,
the biggest bedroom in television history.
You don't need these. You did your research.
It is Dolly magazine.
Do you and your mate relate?
Do you reckon they had to tear out the pages that they had to take out the sealed section?
Yeah.
Which was always dud.
Yeah, it was always about period pain. Every answer was period pain.
Yeah.
And no, because you ride a bicycle, you know, you haven't lost your virginity. That's all it was ever.
Well, how old's a dad?
Ready when you are.
Daddy Warbucks.
Yeah. Oh, is it? Yeah, she's meant to be the.
Veronica's got a brand new horse. And it's
her name's
Garnet.
And she's all yours.
Well, what do you think?
Whose horse is that?
Mine. Isn't she beautiful?
She's okay, I guess.
Oh, Christy's starting to cut grass as the. Mm. As the nasty one.
Oh, I think she's been the worst right from the first time you saw her.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, like I was saying, she's the real deal.
Well, you just said she was beautiful.
How can you say you hate Garnet? She's gorgeous. And she's a fantastic jumper.
Did she just say a fantastic jumper?
Daddy, you said I could pick my own horse.
That's and I want that one.
A fantastic.
So yeah.
Just return
Dad's going to turn around. How much, Wonka?
You can't just return her like she's a pair of shoes.
Shoot Daddy, it.
Please, for me.
He definitely looks embarrassed or something to be there. He's very red in the face. Is he just not well, or is he just going, oh, I'm on a fucking saddle club? They've been talking. You're a stud, but you're an older stud. We don't let any guy on the set if he's not a stud.
Hi, Deborah.
Deborah. It's Max.
It's Max.
Like, who else could it be? There goes, who's Deb? Hi, Deborah.
About the other day.
Not now.
Oh, fuck. Episode 2.
What is it, Ashley?
I can't.
I've got to walk in and...
Did you check the tech room?
I'm going to be a pivotal moment in sabotaging someone's relationship or chances of happiness. She does nothing but sabotage things.
Lust gone out in the tech room again.
Excuse me, there's just one more. So what do you want me to do about it?
Call an electrician?
I'll get to it. Later.
What's he complaining about?
I'm back.
So call a nutrition.
No, don't go.
An electrician.
Yeah, there's an electrical fire currently taking place in the stable.
He doesn't care about anything that goes on.
The wiring shot.
What did Max say?
There is going to be a fire.
There's going to be
a
fire. He'll get around to it.
But he never will.
Stuff some straw in it or something.
He's already got estimates, but it's too expensive.
Well, you don't need an electrician when you've got...
I'm Irish. Yeah. That's the reason the electrical...
Pass me that steel.
Yeah. He's been stealing copper wiring. That's why nothing works now.
Everyone's falling off their horse because their stirrups have...
Give me another chance.
Seriously disappeared.
Great.
This fucking king of the travellers is loading up.
What? No. Of course I'm listening. Dinner and a play.
Dinner and a play. Man from Snow River's on. Let's go watch that.
It's a local repertory theatre doing Pirates of Penzance.
Hello, Deborah.
That's why it doesn't want to go out.
They're dead.
I was just trying to fix the light.
I can't afford any more of your help. Thanks to you, the cost to fix the wiring just doubled.
Come on, Max. It had to be fixed sooner or later.
Okay. I was hoping for later.
Is he showing a torch on them? Oh, no, it's one of the kids.
I still have to fix a broken window.
Doing their lines and some kids showing lights on their faces.
What's wrong with the tractor?
Maybe. No, that's...
I run over a horse in the tractor.
There was this weird noise.
That's the best their lighting budget can go to. Something went wrong. I'll just shine a torch on them. We go, we've got to write this whole...
I thought it was just a reflection off of Max's golden locks.
What's wrong with the way I'm dressed?
You've got straw all over you. Max is wearing jeans, sneakers, and a plaid
sports coat. We need to Eliza coat. Doolittle the fuck out of this guy.
He's having it's the makeover episode. Fu Manchu is an expert. They picked a bouquet.
Cleaning out the car. This is more what I expected a set of club to be like.
Max looks fucking
shit out. Big thumbs
up
to Max. They've got an air freshener leaf hanging from the gonna give him a final pat down.
Straighten the collar. Slip a condom into his top pocket. And some horse tranquilizers.
Ellie Trojans.
Yeah.
So like a horse connection. Is she going to get offended? He's picking her up in that the truck. With this yeah, I guess she's got to stand on the back of it.
Huh? Oh yeah, it totally sucks.
Christy's distracted. She's too busy watching Red rub this horse down.
So tough.
Tell me.
She's not the one that really wants a stallion.
Need any help?
There we go. She's looking for stallion.
Looks like you've already got your hands full.
You bet I do, Red. Don't you know it?
There's always room for more in this hand.
I wonder how Max and Deborah are doing. If I fall asleep before they come back, you have to wake me up. It's so romantic.
Polishing brass is their side business. In the saddle club.
Max's and Deborah's running around Pine Hollow.
Are they having a sleepover? Where are their parents?
You've been reading way too many of these romance
magazines. Oh, is that like in her shed or something?
I cannot give it back.
So is Pine Hollow like a frog weekend school or something?
No, all the time.
It's like it's
24/7.
It's like the Famous Five or something like that. They go out camping whenever they want. We should
have taken your car. This is going to be awkward. They're going to watch Max. The girls are hiding, peering on Max.
On some mezzanine.
Yeah.
Some hay mezzanine thing.
They're going to watch Max and the journalist like
have rough sex. He's going to nail her on the office desk.
We try not to do it at all, actually.
Oh, Max. Call me pasture pal.
They're holding hands. Yeah, but they're talking about manure. Is that a good sign?
Shh.
Why is she putting that in her mouth?
I like you, Max.
Manure.
The horses I could do without.
Me too.
Max is talking about selling.
Yeah, look at this place. The pipes are rusting, the wiring's shot. I'm here 7 days a week. You know what I would give to sleep in just once.
You do fuck all of the place. He's
complaining about Pine Hollow. I thought Max loved everything about this place.
Children of corn. I'm going to kill him. And
maybe
her.
You've outgrown it. It happens.
Yeah. Oh, they are going to like try and sabotage. My father gave. She's it. The bad influence.
Max.
But I wanted to go and be a Broadway star. Or at least work on Neighbours.
But you're right. Okay, I'll sell to the first buyer.
Oh, what? That's how we conduct all this business.
Yeah.
Some crabby lady walks in and goes, I want to see this horse. I plan to make it into gloom. And he goes, he's desperate to sell it. And then she's like, actually, I don't want to pick gloom.
Yeah, don't worry. When all he's going to do is like print out something out of the office and just pin it to the notice board. Business for sale.
These girls are going to somehow raise $75 and then they're going to give it to the Fed for some poisoning racket that's going on.
We were such great matchmakers, so let's be great matchbreakers.
What did they do? They did nothing to get them together.
Yeah, they spruced him up.
Oh, hi, Laura.
Cleaned his car. Took out a Vegemite sandwich, remember?
That's hardly making a match that's already made.
It's just, I'm not very good.
Stevie's had the makeover too. She's got the Stepford wife look.
She does look Stepford wife.
Max's girlfriend.
White headband.
She's got the Alice band, yeah.
Yeah.
She looks like she's doing the kind of Brady Bunch shuffle stuff
yesterday. It sure looks expensive.
I could buy a new truck.
Why is he listening to what these children say to him?
Well, that's what I was going to say. Like when he was conducting the business meeting, I'm surprised that other 8-year-old girl didn't walk in to handle that does all of his handles all of his business.
She's a business advisor.
Yeah,
inherited her
favorite thing. She doesn't like staying in one place for too long.
Well, it's actually starting to make sense that why he's so like socially inept and
Mrs. Charlotte, Max has been looking all
tentative and doesn't care about any of it. He doesn't. Once he might have cared about children riding horses, but then he's like, I don't want to do this anymore.
Yeah.
You'd better talk to Max first.
I've been here all my life. I've never actually been into town apart from seeing Pirates of Penzance.
Don't go in there. Why not? Because Max is sort of busy right now.
She's going to look in and see Max with another woman.
Oh, no. She's in sensible clothing.
Yeah, he's talking to a woman.
Deborah, wait.
It's all over.
Max has a surprise for you.
It's called chlamydia.
Max is taking on a trail ride.
This is creepy. Is she's leading her out into the outer paddock.
Yeah, you're a wicker man.
Look, where is Max?
You just saw him in the office talking to someone 2 seconds ago, you idiot.
No, she's getting really afraid. She's going, I'm just going to ask you.
Well, they're going to make you get on the horse. And it's
going to...
You're
going to do every fucking thing we say to you.
Nothing. It's just, from this angle...
It's like, turn into horse creep.
Yeah, she's going to fall off the horse and do a full Christopher Reeve.
Love him. You don't even have to steer. Patch knows the way.
Oh, they're going to deliberately get her lost.
So, I'll just,
So what, Max?
Not a problem. Down on the and she's gonna fall down jelly bean snake mine.
The wolves, Jelly Bean Mountain.
Yeah, the wolves are going to chase her until she has to jump off of a cliff and land straight down Jelly Bean Snake Mine.
Is it to rough her up a bit so she comes back and her hair's all a mess? She's got dirt on her face and so he goes, oh, you're one of us now.
I guess Mrs. Wright and I were wrong. Deborah said that outfit made you look like
dork.
Like what?
A backcountry hick.
A backcountry hick.
What's a backcountry hick?
That's why you've never met any of your friends. She didn't think they'd understand.
Yeah, that's the next district change. Over.
Backcountry? That school's fucked. I hate those boys at bat school.
This made so much
hunched over riding this where horse.
That's because she's seriously sore between her legs. Will someone like, get me off this thing? They've been doing this set. Look, it's nearly nightfall. She's been riding around the paddock for 5 hours. She's seriously sore.
And just hop off.
Oh. She falls on her ass into her horse and her expensive boots and shit.
My cute one of a kind. Sartori,
it's not
shoes.
Dog shit, it's a horse shit. I had to have them custom made because I've got size 16 feet.
They are big shoes. Yeah.
I guess that's why Laurie always wears riding boots when she goes riding with Max.
Poison the wolves.
Oh, set up.
Deborah, what's wrong?
Why do you call me a bat country hick?
I'm covered in mud. My shoes are ruined.
Well, I'm sorry if you're too good for this place. But if you can't stand a little dirt, then what are you doing in a stable?
You know that I'm afraid of horses. Then you get mad when I don't want to be around them.
Well, I guess I just don't get it. Being a stupid farm boy. Obviously, I'm too dirty for someone as perfect as you.
Obviously, you're better off with one of your many horsey women.
That's right. Hit the brick, sister. Perfect.
They haven't picked up that she's talking about them. Yes. She just thinks they're very short, 55-year-old women.
They bought her a horse without even asking her what she wanted.
This is an awesome horse. Check her out. She's got great legs.
Mm-hmm.
See your ears? She's totally listening to us.
Christy's grinning.
See your mood.
He's talking about me.
I'd kill for a horse like this.
Oh, really?
See, that's not about her at all. She's just worked that in.
Isn't he gorgeous? Garnet's way prettier. Red says she's the best horse he's ever seen at Pine Hollow. Not better than Cobalt.
Yeah, Christy is a bit like Tarantino's character in From Dusk Till Dawn.
Yeah,
she
yeah.
hears conversations that never happen.
Yes, you
yeah.
did. I just said that I wanted my parents to check with me first. That's all. Garnet's not for sale.
That great acting just rolls her eyes. Fuck off, Veronica.
Unless it's a
Here
fight...
Here he is, he's Fu Manchu.
Unless it's a Fight Club thing where Christy's actually the real one. And Veronica's this sweet friend that she's dreamt of.
Yeah, Veronica Durden.
Hello. Sure. Any time after 4? I'll be here.
Electrician.
Thanks.
He's been trying to sell Pine Hollow to the electrician.
Max.
If that's his mum, why doesn't she have the farm? Why does?
Well, that's what I was just about to say. He didn't consult her when he was suddenly going to sell up.
I didn't know you owned real shoes.
I'm not a total backcountry hick.
He's obsessed with his fucking
small element of
insult.
Sure.
Oh, fucked up, Lisa.
Still on for fixing the fence in the west paddy?
I think this is staring into saddle class.
He's going to walk out with it. He's cleaning his shoes. He's going to walk out with the two of them still on his hands. Trying to ride a horse and fix a fence.
He's going to drop to his knees and do the Stella thing. With a couple of shoes on his hand.
Sorry to bother you. Jake forgot to turn off the hose after he watered the horses this morning.
What?
Okay.
No, see, there's a huge flood in 3 of the stalls.
I'm sure you can handle it.
Because I don't give a shit about this place. If no one buys it, I'm burning it down.
This is going to end with Max hanging himself from the rafters.
See, I
He's going to make Max was here.
A noose out of one of the many sashes.
I've never seen him like this before.
He's miserable. It's all
so Stephen needs to put the famous denim jacket on to fix this problem. So they're all in their respective colours except for Stevie.
She's Carol's always in purple.
Mm-hmm.
Stevie's always in that vest.
We're the ones who rescued
Deborah. Stevie's in the denim jacket.
So oh, sorry, Lisa.
To get them back together. That means we lose Pine Hollow. We'll always find another stable, but there's only one Max.
No, there's only one Saddle Club.
Mm.
Please, Max, you have to come.
Why don't you get Stevie or Carol to go with you?
They're busy, and I need someone to go on the trail with me. Prance has been acting really spooky.
You know, because you're right, the teacher and you should be supervising.
Yeah.
Get all this paperwork done. Let's go.
Have you ever achieved anything, Max, at this place?
Mrs. Reg, are you busy?
No more than usual. That guy's seriously depressed. That's really, it's really sad episode.
Saddle Club having its meeting in the field today, is it?
It's not
he was probably, like, took his first steps in the stable and now his dad's gone. He's working the family business. He had no choice. He hates all these girls. He just has no interest in any of it, rather.
That's because he died when Veronica was... He was giving Veronica a piggyback and he fell over and broke his leg.
And
he was shot.
He had to shoot his dad.
Yeah.
Convincing the old owner to take her back.
Daddy, if you don't let me have Garnet, I'll die. Look how much she loves me.
Okay, you can have the horse.
Maybe he can buy Pine Hollow.
Where are we going? I thought this was supposed to be a quick interview for your school project.
Oh, I thought she thought she was being dragged on a date.
Get a better mark if you choose a creative background.
Here we are. She's meant to be the...
What's this?
Yeah, she's a journalist, but she works for the local rag.
Mm.
She works part-time. That's enough to be the journalist and the editor and the
printer. They've set up a picnic to get Max and the journalist back together.
You probably wouldn't want to.
Yeah, I thought
alone.
The three girls.
No.
We like you to
someone
watch.
Like to tell me what's going on.
Look, I should go.
No, wait. You can't.
First
it's
up.
All our fault. Max doesn't really have
a lot. It's a very somber moment because Stevie's wearing a black jumper.
And Deborah never dropped off those travel brochures. We're really sorry, but we didn't want you to sell Pine Hollow.
What? Who told you that?
And they think that if they get these two together...
You said you were going to sell it to the first buyer who
he'll want
along.
To stay. They'll get married.
I'd never sell Pine Hollow.
We were talking about his truck. It's a death trap.
So you never said...
I'd die before I left this place.
That'll teach you
and I'll take you with me.
Oops.
We should be going now. See you back at the stable.
Hold it.
You can at least have a sandwich.
You think... You can wreck a man's life and get away with it.
We're really, really sorry.
I don't think that's good enough. You deserve to be punished.
Definitely.
None. See that cliff?
But my mother's will make sandwiches for you.
That's cruel.
Oh, yes.
We've never seen your mother make a fucking sandwich yet. Don't try and make it like that's a pivotal plot point in Saddle Club.
Are we good or what? If we hadn't have broken them up in the first place, then they wouldn't have been as happy to get back together. Another excellent
from the essentially they get the trophy again. Well, at least Veronica got a horse, so that's all right.
Yeah, and Christy misheard horse commentary.
He's decided that
the red loves everything about her.
Yeah. Suddenly starts dropping in conversation. You know what my best part is? My legs and my ears. I've got nice ears for listening. So is this the last episode of the season?
No.
Oh, okay. Does the song sound sad to you?
Yeah. I don't know if they've changed it a lot, but this one does.
Yeah.
They're doing it at gunpoint.
It's getting into more serious storylines, feelings, and
I'll see ya.
Bye.